kids, in our lecture number 5, we will be studying the third type of number line, which is generally as under root of x, and your x would be always be in point form. Okay, so now in today's lecture, we'll be completing our chapter with this number line and exercise 1.6. Okay, now here we have, suppose, under root 3.5. This is your x, which is under root form, and it will be always be in point form. So here what we will be doing is, we'll be making a line with the measurement of 4.5 centimeter. Means 3.5 plus 1 centimeter. Correct? We will be 3.5 plus 1. Means you have to make a line of 3.5 centimeter, then extend it to 1 centimeter. So this will become your 4.5 centimeter. Now do the half of this. That is equal to 2.25. Means you have to mark 2.25 on the number line. Such that this point is half of your line. Now take the measurement from center to and check whether it is equal on both the sides or not. Yes, it is equal on both the sides. Now make a half arc. Okay, this is your half arc. Now what you have to do is measure 3.5 and make a point over there. This is your 3.5 centimeter, this is your 1 centimeter. Join with 90 degree. You have to take 90 degree and join the line on the circle. Correct? What we first did was, we made a line of 3.5 centimeter plus 1 centimeter. Then I took the half and made this half circle. Then I took the measurement of 3.5 and on the 90 degree, I joined this line on our curve. Now measure this line. Suppose I give them the name. Measure this line AB. Okay, I have measured this line AB. Now make the arc. Okay, now this point on your number line is under root 3.5. Understood what we did? We made the line, we divided it into half, we made the circle using that as radius, took 3.5 centimeter of measurement, drawn the perpendicular line, took the measurement of this line, and then I draw a arc, which is your required root 3.5 on the number line. Now you can extend this number line, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. You need not to write that thing, you just make this line, and this is your required number line. I hope you all understood this number line. For more practice, we will be solving question number 4 of exercise 1.5 in homework, that is under root 9.3. For here, what you will be doing, I'll be giving you a hint. Make a line of 9.3 centimeter, further 1 centimeter wala line, take half, draw the circle, join this to the circle, and then on the line, which is your required number line. Okay, now coming to the next part, that is laws of exponents of real number. It is same as that we studied in previous classes, what are the laws of the natural number. Same as that, but here you will be getting fractions as the power. Okay, so first we'll be discussing the laws. The laws are, first, a raised to m multiplied by a raised to n. Means if base is same, power is different, and they are in multiplication, then power will be adding. If they are in division, base is same, power is different, then we will be subtracting them on the basis of which one is greater. Here, if we have one base and two powers, then those two powers will be multiplied. Then base is different, power is same. So we will multiply the base and power will be 1. If a raised to 0 is there, then it is always 1. If a raised to n is there, then it is always a raised to minus n, means inverse ho jayega. Okay, these are the exponents we studied in our previous classes. So let us solve these sums based on this topic. Let us take example number 21 for solving it. What our example number 21 says is, first, 2 the power 2 by 3 multiplied by 2 the power 1 by 3. See, here we can see the property of a raised to m into a raised to n. Base is same, but power is different. So this is equal to, what does this equal to? A raised to m plus n, correct? So here also we can write 2 by 3 plus 1 by 3. That is 2 to the power 3 by 3. That is 2 to the power 1, which is your required answer. Correct? Now coming to the second part of example 21, that is 3 to the power 1 by 5, the whole power 4. Here we can see the property of a raised to m, the whole raised to n. 1 base and 2 power, what we used to do is multiply both the powers. So here we will get 3 raised to 1 by 5 multiplied by 4, that is 3 raised to 4 by 5. Correct? Now coming to third part. 7 raised to 1 by 5 upon 7 raised to 1 by 3. Here we have the identity of a raised to m upon a raised to n. So we used to do a raised to m minus n. Same here. 7 raised to 1 by 5 minus 1 by 3. What will be the answer? We will be taking the LCM first. So 15, 3 minus 5 by 15. 7 raised to 3 minus 5 by 15. That is 7 raised to minus 2 by 15. Correct? See, this though I think you know, while doing fraction, if the denominator are not same, we take LCM first. And fourth part is 13 raised to 1 by 5 into 17 raised to 1 by 5. Here, base is different but power is same. So what we used to do, base multiply raised to power 1. तो इसका क्या हो जाएगा बच्चा 13 into 17 raised to 1 by 5. तो 13 into 17 कितना होता है 2 to 1 raised to 1 by 5, which is your required answer. Now coming to the exercise. In exercise, we will be solving first second of each, and rest you have to do for homework. Now in exercise 1.6, question number 1 says, find first 64 raised to half. Now you would be saying, ma'am, यहाँ पे तो कोई operation ही नहीं है, तो हम कैसे solve करेंगे? कैसे solve करेंगे बच्चा? हम 64 को ऐसे number में divide करेंगे जिसका prime factorization करेंगे हम 64 का, ठीक है? 64 का prime factorization करो तो क्या आएगा? क्या हुआ? 64 equals to 2 raised to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? सब 64 का power half है, तो 2 raised to 6 का भी power half होगा, correct? तो ये क्या होगा? 2 raised to 6 multiply by half, 2 बनजा, 2 3जा, तो क्या आया? 2 raised to 3, which is your 8, correct? Easy था. Coming to the second part, 32 raised to 1 by 5, सेम 32 का पहले आप प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन करोगे, करेक्ट? तो 32 इक्वल्स टू क्या है बच्चा? 2 रेज टू 5 आया. अब 32 रेज टू 1 बाय 5 है, तो मतलब क्या होगा? 2 रेज टू 5 रेज टू 1 बाय 5 होगा. तो 2 रेज टू 5 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 1 बाय 5, 5 5 कट, तो योर आंसर इज 2, करेक्ट? इजी. नाउ कमिंग टू द सेकंड क्वेश्चन. First part, 9 raised to 3 by 2, correct? 9 का prime factorization करो, 9 क्या हुआ? 3 square, तो 9 raised to 3 by 2 क्या होगा? 3 square का 3 by 2, तो 3 raised to 2 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 3/2, करेक्ट। तो 3 raised to 3 आया, 3 raised to 3 क्या होता है 27। ओके सेकेंड पार्ट, 32 raised to 2/5, द सेम वी डिड अप। तो हम डायरेक्ट दे 32 equals to 2 raised to 5, तो 32 raised to 2/5 क्या होगा 2 raised to 5 raised to 2/5, तो 2 raised to 5 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2/5, तो 2 square दैट इज 4, करेक्ट। दिस इज वेरी इजी बेटा। नाउ कमिंग टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, फर्स्ट हियर यू विल बी यूजिंग द आइडेंटिटीज। हियर आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग यू द फोर्थ ऑल द फोर क्वेश्चन। सी हियर बेस इज सेम, पावर इट इज डिफरेंट, तो यू विल बी एडिंग दिस टू यूजिंग LCM। हियर सी, ओके विल बी सॉल्विंग सेकेंड पार्ट, 1/3 raised to 3 का 7। नाउ 7 विल बी कमिंग ऑन 1 ऑल्सो, विल बी कमिंग ऑन 3 ऑल्सो, सो दिस इज 1 raised to 7 अपॉन 3 raised to 3 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 7, दैट इज 1 upon 1 raised to 7 इज 7 ओनली, 3 raised to 21 विच इज योर आंसर। हाँ, क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 अगेन, इट इज़ इन फ्रैक्शन सॉरी डिवीजन फॉर्म, तो 1/2 minus 1/4 यू विल बी सॉल्विंग इट यूजिंग LCM। हियर बेस इज सेम, बेस इज डिफरेंट, पावर इज सेम, तो यू विल बी मल्टीप्लाइंग 7 multiplied by 8 होल पावर हाफ। ओके विद दिस वी कंप्लीट द चैप्टर। थैंक यू सो मच।